So hey guys, in this video we're gonna talk about the medium that was assigned to electromagnetic waves. So let's get it done. I know you guys know that electromagnetic waves do not require medium to propagate, but this was not always the case. As scientists in 19th century were so much used to the mechanical picture of wave propagation that they thought there must be some medium pervading all space and all matter, which responds to the electric and magnetic field of the electromagnetic wave, just as any elastic medium does. They call this medium ether, also spelled as E-T-H-E-R. They were so convinced of the reality of this medium that there is even a novel called The Poison Belt, written by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, in which the solar system is supposed to pass through a poisonous region of ether. In case you don't know who this guy is, he is the creator of the famous detective Sherlock Holmes.
Oh God! Stupid idea. Whose idea was that?
This ether theory was in play only until the Michelson Morley experiment. This is a cool experiment, so let's take a few minutes to understand this experiment. In Michelson Morley experiment, we have a point source, a detector, and a glass that allow half of the light to pass and half to reflect, called half silver mirror or beam splitter, and two mirrors at equal distances from the center of the glass. When light from light source reaches the glass, it splits into two waves. When these waves reflect back and meet at the glass, they superimpose and produce an interference pattern on detector. Now, if they reach at the same time, then a bright pattern will appear because of the constructive interference of the waves. If not, then the bright spot will not appear. Before proceeding further, let me introduce a new term, ether wind. According to hypothesis, Earth and ether are in a relative motion, implying that a wind of ether flows all over the Earth. Suppose the direction of ether winds are away from the detector. Then if I rotate the whole system by a certain angle, then the light waves will not reach the glass at the same time, and the constructive interference will not occur, and bright spot will not form. So if ether exists, we must have a variety of interference pattern on rotating the system. But this does not happen. The only pattern observed is bright. Meaning, no matter how you rotate the system, the light waves reach the detector at the same time. Therefore, the luminiferous ether, or just ether, does not exist. This experiment was a failure in a mission to prove the existence of ether. But this experiment was a pioneer in demolition of ether theory and initiated a line of research that eventually led to special relativity. Then after, the electromagnetic waves are free to explore the universe without any medium. So thanks for watching this video. I hope you have learned something new from this video, and if you did, make sure you subscribe my channel, because I'll post more educational videos like this, and I'm sure you don't want to miss on that. And again, thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye.